everybody. This is MoCo's Most Famous. I'm Joe Yasharoff, Director of Content at Montgomery Community Media in Rockville. Today, we're talking to Eun Yang, anchor and reporter for NBC4, and most importantly, a Paint Branch High School alum, University of Maryland alum. She is about 7,000 miles away in Tokyo covering the Olympics. Eun, cannot thank you enough for taking the time out from your long days. How are you doing?
Joe, thanks for having me. You know, it's a grind. Is one of the best assignments you'll ever get, but the toughest for sure. The days are very long. There's a lot of moving around. It's very, very hot here in Tokyo, but to tell the stories of these incredible Olympians who have sacrificed so much and dedicated their lives to representing Team USA and competing on the world stage during these unprecedented circumstances with so much grace and so much class has been truly a joy to see.
Now, I know you've covered popes, inaugurations, a lot of big events. I mean, you've been doing this for a long time. Where does covering this Olympics rank in your career so far?
Definitely one of the highlights. I will say I went to the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics 5 years ago now, and because it was in South Korea where my family is from and it is such a part of my heritage, that was truly the high point for me to go to Korea where I speak the language and interact with people who were so proud to represent their country. But the Tokyo Olympics right under that, especially because I think this was such a unique experience in terms of this country dealing with COVID. Athletes who've had to overcome so much for training. A lot of the swimmers we talked to had to find backyard pools. They're working out in home gyms, didn't really have a lot of time to do their regular routines, but they still had to focus on getting in their best shape to come here to the Olympics. And I think they were just grateful for the opportunity to actually compete because they weren't sure if the Olympics would happen. So to see the dedication and the triumph, the Olympic spirit, so to speak, to bring people together. People have said this particular Olympics was an Olympics of kindness. To see the Olympians show so much sportsmanship, so much gratitude, spending time with each other, lifting each other up, that has been especially wonderful to see at this Olympics in Tokyo.
Sure. Now, you're known as a news reporter. Is it any transition at all for you? Now, Olympics is more than just sports, obviously. There's stories and there, you know, stories of human sacrifice and accomplishment. Is it any kind of transition for you to go from news reporter to kind of sports reporter as well?
You know, I think the best sports reporters are storytellers, just like news reporters. And I think that's one thing that we love about sports. It's not just about the competition. It is about those stories. My favorite stories often come from sports because there are so many things that happen behind the scenes that we don't get to see. Like you said, sometimes it's not just a sacrifice of what these athletes put their bodies through, but their home lives, the time away from their families. You know, I just had a chance to interview Suni Lee, the gold medalist in the individual all-arounds, and, you know, her family struggled. She's Hmong American, the first to ever be on a U.S. Olympic team, the first Asian American to win the all-around individual gold medal, and to shine a light on the fact that not all Asian Americans fit the stereotype of, oh, we had this successful upbringing and we fit this mold of a particular type of family that people see, that she truly shows that there were struggles in her family. Her dad was recently paralyzed in an accident. They couldn't afford a balance beam, so he built one out of wood in their backyard. She overcame so many struggles, self-doubt to be here. Whether you don't even care about a particular sport, the stories of human spirit and triumph here in victory and defeat, I think that brings people together and why people love the Olympics no matter what.
Absolutely. And I know you're doing reports every day for NBC4. It seems like you're on all the time. It seems like you're not sleeping at all. I see you in the morning. I see you at night. Are you sleeping at all?
I'm not sleeping. I'm not saying that that's okay. I really do believe that I'm one of those people who can function on less sleep. My doctor tells me it's not the healthiest, but I think my early morning schedule at home prepares me for the grind of the Olympics because I don't get a lot of sleep. I have three children, raising a family, trying to live my life, spending time with my husband and my friends. And so I do want to have somewhat of a normal life, but it's hard on my insane schedule. So here, when you know you have early hours, late hours, some events are really late, some live shots. After my live shots, I have to go, you know, cover more interviews, that sort of thing. And so I think that is one thing. Hard work is something I've been preparing for, and same with the weather in DC. So here at the Olympics, it hasn't been that much of a transition. The jet lag was tough in the first few days, but hard work is not so much.
Yeah, so speaking of taking care of yourself, Simone Biles, that is clearly the biggest story. Well, I think it's the biggest story of the Olympics. How has that story been covering from your perspective?
Oh my goodness, I think that really is the story of these Olympics this time around. I think people have not been in her shoes. I don't think anyone could say they understand what it's like to be the greatest of all time in a sport that is so, so difficult. She completes moves that no one else can do. She is putting herself in the air and doing turns and acrobatics that you fathom to begin to even practice. She's doing this under tremendous pressure on the spotlight in the arena of people expecting you to perform. She has nothing to prove. And as she has practiced and practiced and sacrificed and prepared for this moment to step away and say, you know what? My body and mind aren't in sync. I am not fully feeling like myself. I don't want to put myself in danger. And listen, this is not just any old cut. You see the kinds of things she does. If her mind is not in the right place, she could not only injure herself, I can imagine she could kill herself on one of these apparatus, right? I mean, you look at the vault, you look at the uneven bars. And so I think what Simone did was very courageous. I think the conversation has been going, but she puts extra spotlight in the fact that it's okay to have a conversation about it and to pull away and put yourself first. And I think we can all take a lesson from Simone Biles after these Olympics on what it's like to be a true champion and to really have some compassion and understanding about what we put these athletes what we put them on a pedestal, and right, that they're human as well. And I think that was a very, very important message here in Tokyo.
Very, very well said. I want to ask you, so far, do you have one favorite moment? Is there one moment that you're going to keep thinking about for years and years so far?
Oh, I get so emotional at the Olympics when we see first-time Olympians who win gold or win a medal at all for their country. It's so gratifying to see anyone who shows so much pride in representing their country here in front of the world. I am biased to see Katie Ledecky win the gold repeated, and the 800 meter freestyle was magnificent. I think, talk about someone who has a target on her back. She's also the greatest of all time. And she is so gracious and so kind and such a class act. You know, when she wins, she goes to the next person and says, "You did an awesome job." She goes to who won the gold medal in the 400 meter and plated her. She is a champion in every respect of the word. And my goal was to come here to interview Katie is always special. And she, when she saw me, she said, "Oh, my hometown anchor." So nice. That's always flattering to know that she knows that I'm from her hometown, and that gives us a special connection.
Speaking of hometown, so you're a Paint Branch High School alum, University of Maryland alum. So have you heard from old friends in high school and kind of any local besides the Katie Ledecky hometown greeting, anything like that?
You know, it's fun to ask people. For example, Jeremy Grant, who plays for the Pistons, went to DeMatha Catholic High School in Hyattsville, and I was able to do what's called a mix zone, an interview after one of the quarterfinals. KD had to do a press conference, so he couldn't stop. But Jeremy Grant is from DeMatha, and he has a connection to Washington. His dad, Harvey Grant, played for Washington for more than 10 years. And he said, "I love DC, love representing Team USA and the area." And he's so thankful for the support. So any kind of hometown connection I can get from here is always great to see. We have Tina Charles. I've been trying to follow all the local athletes. I can't list them all. Noah Lyles is about to compete here in the 200 meter. He is favored to win gold from Alexandria, and he always goes back to Alexandria and talks to kids and keeps in touch with his former school principal. So all these things, she's an educator. I don't think principal is her official title, but all these athletes, that hometown connection makes it special for me. I mean, that's why I'm here, right?
I wanted to ask you, so we are trained journalists. We're trained to be objective, but once in a while, I'll become a fanboy. Is there anyone that makes you a fangirl, if I may ask?
Oh, yes. I am an Allison Felix super fan. She just finished and advanced to the finals in the 400 meter. Mm-hmm. She has been in 5 Olympics. This is stunning to me. 5 Olympics. She was 18 years old in Athens. She is now a mother. And she is not only representing Team USA in one of the toughest races, she is advocating for other athletes who are mothers, talking about how important it is to get childcare so you can be at your best and compete and not have to worry. She had a very difficult pregnancy and birth, and she says she's here for your daughter, for her daughter. And as a working mom myself, she is just such a terrific human being. And so if I haven't had a chance to meet her, I would fully fangirl all over her if I had a chance to meet Allison.
All right, and that I know we have to wrap up here. So I wanted to ask you, so for the young girls, the young boys who are listening, or it doesn't have to be young girls and boys, who want to be a reporter, who think what you're doing is the coolest thing in the world, what would you say to them?
I would say, dream big. I feel like the Olympics has rubbed off on me because that's what the Olympians say. Dream big, work hard. And I really do believe if you are curious, you're a good listener, because you have to listen to ask the right questions, and you love stories and you love people, that you can also do this job. I really do believe that, and go for it. Go for it. We need journalists. We need storytellers in the world.
We do indeed. And thank you. I cannot thank you enough for doing this, really. I know how busy you are. And you can check out Eun Yang on NBC4 mornings, nights, every 24/7, I think. Paint Branch High School grad.
Woo! Paint Branch, go Terps! Go Panthers!
University of Maryland alum. Thank you so much for doing this.
Thanks for having me, Joe. Appreciate it.
All right. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you so much.
Thanks again for joining us on MoCo's Most Famous. Good luck the rest of the way again to Eun Yang in Tokyo. I'm Joe Yasharoff. Hope you enjoyed this episode of MoCo's Most Famous. Have a great day and see you next time.
Information is key. To stay informed on what's happening in Montgomery County, like, share, and subscribe to our channel.